right, peeps. This is another version of Ask the Black Woman. Mouthpieces on the scene in Grand Park. And I met this gorgeous lady named Vanessa. Is this your boo thing to the left, Drew?
This is my husband.
This is the real boo thing. Forever boo thing, Drew. And they've agreed to ask this black woman a question today. I literally just ran up on them, so I don't know what she's going to ask. So I'm blessed to have this dialogue. Yeah. Whenever you're ready, pretty.
As a woman of color, how do you feel, let's say when you're going to go to be on set or be on screen, and then a makeup artist doesn't know how to do your skin tone, doesn't have the shades, and then, or it's even become an acceptable thing for women of color to bring their own foundation because makeup artists can't match their tone, or they don't know how to work with textured hair. How does that make women of color feel that, you know, as professionals we can't cater to all skin types, or even that the industry doesn't cater to all skin types? Like, there's sometimes limited ranges, and that's something that bothers me because I'm well versed in all skin tones. One of my first jobs is working for an extension and wig company, so I had to learn very quickly. But it makes me really upset when I see that happening in the industry, and it's people calling themselves professionals when they can't do everything. You know, can't work with textured hair, they can't work with, or women of color are asked to bring their own makeup.
The devil. She got a good one, y'all.
Good one.
She gave me layers, so I'm going to try to unpack it piece by piece here. So, I will say, I have been pretty fortunate that for the majority of my experience performing, there have been women who know how to work with my skin tone. Not just black women, but the last thing I was on was a little small indie film, but it was another woman of color. She just wasn't black. But she beat my face, for real. Like, she was great. I'll tell you, not necessarily with makeup, though. With this production I'm doing for Aladdin, when I went to look for dancing tights and shoes, the dancing shoes, so I forget the names of them or whatever. That's the thing that gets me, that there's such a lack of color in 2017.
Right. The nudes.
The nudes. So I'm having to wear tights that are your color.
Yeah, that's so true. That's crazy.
And so the people that dance, like, this is their thing 24/7. They're like, oh, you got a diet and coffee and all that. Like, are you out your damn mind? And even the shoes. So it looks so off with my skin tone that I'm trying to do that. And I have to wear, because they want stuff to be in and tight and all of this kind of thing. So that's the, I feel like what they don't realize, I mean, I think, well, for the most part, people realize that black women, we are a $1 trillion industry. And so it would behoove them to find the niche and optimize that. Like, knowing that you already know that it's a lack of diversity and still in the makeup part or whatever. And now what I just discovered, like I said, wearing an awful color on my skin for those dancing tights and them shoes. It was really, I hated it. I absolutely hated it.
Like, we were talking about my bra today. He's like, I can't tell if, you know, whatever.
Yeah, I love that first one.
I love it.
So, but that's something that I know that women of color have to deal with a lot of the time, because they can't find stuff that matches, or, you know, it's like very apparent. You can see it through.
Wait, that, you matter of fact, one, and they cost the arm and a leg, the bigger your breasts are. But I had on one of my strapless or whatever, but I remember going to, where was I at? Not Neiman's or whatever. All I know, they were all still your color. There was nothing near my color at all. But I had to get that sucker. So even when I wear with like a sundress or something, that bad boy pops up. I just feel like it looks a big ass distraction, like, for real.
It just bugs you.
It do. It straight up do. But there are smaller companies that are trying to come out with stuff. They're doing all kinds of crowdfunding sources. These are like sisters that's trying to get in the niche, but they don't have no money to really kick it off like they want to. None of the bigger companies are really trying to like go there with it. Even how they do like in certain neighborhoods though too. I used to be able to buy the Queen Collection makeup at the Walgreens and Miracle Mile off of Wilshire. Up until like about a month ago. I mean, I literally just ran out of powder and stocked like about a month and a half ago. I came back there was, I said, well, the whole section, you guys like don't have it at all? I think like they just eliminate whole sections of it.
You know, that's a really good versatile line for like setting powders. I like Ben Nye. Ben Nye is a professional line, but it's pretty inexpensive.
Okay.
But they have all shades. Like I have this beautiful palette that has like 8 different colors, but very warm, like a lot of like golds and reds.
Now bring me out.
Like I know it's perfect. Like they come with a lot of. So if you go to Nanies,
which spell that.
N A
I M
I E S, and it's in Studio City.
It's right off the 101 Riverside Drive.
No.
Or 170.
Laurel, he doesn't know what he's talking about.
I drive there all the time.
It's the 101 in Laurel Canyon.
I'm going to shut my mouth.
Gotcha.
101 in Laurel Canyon.
Okay. Yeah. Name.
Yeah, but it is off of Riverside, but it's not off the, that's not the exit. But in Canyon.
Yeah.
Okay. So, but yeah, Ben Nye is really good.
Okay.
Yeah.
But she dropped one on me, guys. Like, for real. It just made me think. I think it's also an extension that, just like how it's taken a while for people to realize the average size of an American woman, mm-hmm. as far as like bringing cuter things for plus size yeah. women and stuff like that. I feel like it's always been this cookie cutter thing. I don't know what it's going to take for them to realize the gorgeousness.
Yeah.
Okay, like you've probably seen the things I do find offensive is this. Okay. The videos that have been coming, maybe within the last year, of them hiring someone who did not know how to, I forgot what Good Morning America show, whatever it is, but they were trying to do fun summer hairstyles or something like that. You saw that video?
I saw it.
And they jacked up that sister's head.
They're brushing it out.
Her hair, I know what she did. I could look at her hair and tell you what that sister did to make her hair look that gorgeous when she showed up. She braided it down in big dookie braids or whatever. Uh-huh. Woke up with that nice puff. Because if you don't braid that texture down at night, the sucker looks matted in the morning.
Yeah.
Or whatever. It does the shrinkage thing with our hair. So that sister braided her hair down, went to bed like that or whatever, took it out, finger combed it, and was walking out with her crown of glory. And they got this gal up here who don't know nothing about our hair. That was a freaking insult. That stuff went freaking viral.
It was awful. They just started trying to brush her hair out, and it was just awful.
And it left someone like they literally did it, and all of us sat there in horror watching like, what? Yep, that was real. So those kinds of videos. So. But thank you, Vanessa, for letting me break up you and the boo things. Time.
No problem.
Y'all so sweet. I'm going to turn it off.